So just stepping into the other piece that Hemant touched upon, so I'm also a believer that more than the foundry side of it, we should be really focusing on the design companies. So if you look at a typical $20 SoC silicon, and again, this is just a rule of thumb I'm just taking, like probably around $7 cost goes into the die itself from the fab company, and then probably another $2 for packaging, assembly, and test, right? Another buck or so for the royalties towards the IP, and then close to $10 based on 50% gross margin for the product company, basically. So how can we really address as much of a market as possible on the semiconductor side for this upcoming rush towards 2020? So definitely, if we can encourage more design companies in India, it is going to be, that's a bigger piece, as you can see, almost half the money there is actually from the design companies. So if we can figure out a way to encourage the product companies, it will be better. And the same thing with respect to encouraging the IP companies. We have a lot of talent already available in this, in both these areas. And the local assembly test mark and packaging. So these guys, I mean, we have been seeing a few companies for the last few years. And definitely, I think this talent is already there. And this is a lot less capital intensive. And the last one, which everybody talks about, is the fab companies. So my point is basically on the top three points, basically, right? So the lesser investment is required. And we already have most of the talent pool available in India. And actually, the assembly and test kind of goes closely with the R&D of a product. On the contrary, probably like the negative aspect is it's very fragmented. So there is a bigger strategy and vision required to enable this kind of ecosystem for the future success here. On the fabs, everybody knows about the large investments needed. And the good point here is it's easily controlled at the point of manufacturing. So if I can figure out a strategy to just have, I mean, 2 to 4, what a few foundry companies, I can definitely address some of this money completely coming out of India. So just going into the last couple of slides before Pradeep signals to me. So obviously, as I discussed, there's always a comparison with China. So just trying to look at China from this perspective. So if you look at the current Chinese semiconductor consumption, almost 40% of the worldwide semiconductor consumption is in China, and a third of that actually goes into the domestic market. And their domestic companies, what kind of value they are adding to these domestic consumption? So their test and assembly revenues are doing very good, and almost 38% of the worldwide sales, and the manufacturing side, again, with all their manufacturing prowess and the kind of focus they got for the last decade or so on getting the foundry companies in, they're still not doing that good with respect to the IC manufacturing. They're doing good with respect to the discretes, especially around LEDs and some of that. Like LEDs, almost 35% of the worldwide output is from China. And look at the design revenues, actually. So it's actually growing very well. And I mean, as you can see, back in 2000, it's like $130 million market. And now, actually, they are at almost $5 billion. And this is going at a very fast rate. So there are almost 500 IC design companies in China, and only 100 or so from MNCs. So that means there are 400 local companies in China. So that is a big contrast compared to India here. So from my perspective, I mean, I see that this assembly and test, they're definitely doing very good. So that's why I gave it green. And the IC manufacturing fab is always going to be a difficult piece. I think they're still figuring out how to make it a successful piece here. And there is a lot more focus coming around the IC design piece, basically. So that's the reason why I put that in orange, actually. The key statistic I figured out, actually, was almost 30 out of the 42 worldwide semiconductor IPOs are from China. So definitely, there is a big traction happening in China around the design companies and overall in the semiconductor segment. So you can just see the footnote there. So pretty much the fabless product companies are going to be the game changer for them in the future, and expanding at a fabulous rate of 36% per year. So just to summarize, to second Hemant's opinion, so I'm going to say the same thing, that there's bigger focus required around the design companies and potentially assembly and test rather than foundries. and probably from encouraging more startups here, we need a lot more bootstrap setups. That would be definitely a big plus for the local ecosystem. And then worldwide, I think this is definitely required for the semiconductor industry itself to succeed in the long run, to not reduce the innovation levels dropping down. So definitely, this is already going to be a problem, and there are a lot of initiatives happening worldwide to increase more money going into semiconductor startups and probably encourage them. So that's all I have.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Balaji. A round of applause for Balaji. And I think, he talked about less money now coming into this sector and therefore the need for frugal engineering. And I think let's hold on to this and perhaps, later we'll come back to this and we'll have a discussion on this.